during your trying
walking.
It's the latest
thing.
Incontestably proven health benefits let you
kill two birds
with one
stone.
You can see the sights and keep those cholesterol levels
down
at the same
time.
Yes.
Bright Falls Sheriff Station. How may I...
Hello? Hello?
Oh boy!
Well then.
The bulldozer had gone over the cliff with the office. I hoped Stucky had suffered the same fate, but I wasn't planning on staying to find out.
Oh, thank you.
There were more of them. I'd never fired a gun outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone, or something. There were no bodies. They just disappeared. If I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick. Eerie hand-painted graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it.
Hiding around here? Any pieces of paper? Maybe a coffee thermos? Maybe.
The dark forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
Shame.
Rose knew she had been gushing, but right now, she didn't care. As far as she was concerned, her brief meeting with Alan Wake was literally the high point of her life. She watched as he got in the car with his wife. She was pretty, confident, at ease with Wake. Not like Rose. They were perfect for each other. She'd have given anything to be called their friend. What was that?
Creepy noises in the woods. Creepy noises in the woods. Don't like the creepy noises in the woods.
When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
Lies!
Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me. Harry Wheeler was bouncing off the walls. He jumped on a plane after his calls were ignored by both Al and Alice for several days. It could mean that they were both on a second honeymoon, but Barry didn't buy it. Al had been way too unstable for that, not sleeping, messed up. Barry had years of experience dealing with Alan Wake, and he couldn't ignore it. Something was wrong.
It's just me. I do enjoy games that have like that atmospheric storytelling. The manuscripts in this, the stories you find just by looking a little bit further. It makes games more interesting in my opinion.
For a long time, the dark presence had been weak, sleeping. Nothing but a half-forgotten nightmare or a shadowy flicker in the corner of an eye in the forest at night. Not real enough to properly exist, and yet too evocative to fade away completely. Now it was waking up. The rider like a fly caught in a spider's web, each jerk and kick vibrating the strands that led deep into its lair. It was aware of him now, and it could use him. All he'd need was a little incentive. They're taken.
Well, the sign said, taken or filled with darkness. My mind went blank as I was reading it. I need more batteries, and then I can have max batteries.
The staircase was broken. I had to make my way up some other way.
That head on a swivel. You know, I'm a fucked up person, but I do that in real life too. Always kind of swivel back and forth, make sure you're watching both sides.
Damn it. Damn it.
I heard them before I saw them, swooping down from the sky and screeching as they came. I spun around just as the cloud was upon me. For an instant, I stared into 100 dead eyes, black pearls glittering in the darkness. I raised the flashlight and the swarm exploded like fireworks. Feathers burned, turned into ash. I couldn't hear my scream above theirs.
Like that, you get like papers that are foreshadowing for, oh hey, crowds of birds, hit him with a flashlight. Oh, that didn't take a long time. And wouldn't you know it, it logged up perfectly. I had a seed of a doubt there.
Just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now, but if you're still up and around, take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in deep. The weather is absolutely still. The sky is crystal clear. It's like the forest is quietly breathing along with you. As you listeners know, I'm a night owl, and it's on nights like this I wish I wasn't cooped up in the studio. Makes an old man like me wish I could just roam wild. But here I am, and who'd keep you company all night long if I weren't? It looks like I'm not the only one staying up late. Caller, you're on the air.
Hey, Pat, it's Maurice Horton.
Hello, Maurice. What are you up to?
Well, I was just taking Toby on his walkies.
Oh, isn't it beautiful out there?
Sure, but Pat, the reason I called is that Toby heard something rustling in the undergrowth and took off after it, and I couldn't find it.
Probably a rabbit.
Toby loves rabbits.
Well, sure.
Anyway, I figured that, you know, if anyone runs into Toby, they could grab him. My number's on his collar.
And Toby's a friendly dog?
Toby loves people. Usually he comes back, but we were pretty far from home, and it sounds like he went pretty wild there. Great dog, but he's just too dumb for his own good.
Well, Maurice, it's out there now. Hope Toby comes home soon.
Yeah, thanks, Pat.
You have a good night now.
Swear to God, if I kill a dog here in a little bit, I'm gonna be mad. Man, a lot of supplies, huh? More flare gun! And if that don't work, more flare gun.
At first, I kept finding the pages as if by accident. The book I couldn't remember was either a terrible and true prophecy, or an act of creation that had rewritten the world. I began to hunt the pages feverishly, for they held the answer to the mystery. With it, I could save myself. With it, I could save Alice. The gas station was closer now, its light welcoming in the darkness.
Paul makes the best
dogs in the state.
Belly Burster is the best with no
monster dog
is second best. The famous dog is...
That's where they want to go.
Tells me though they're probably going to be coming. It's like, oh, oh.
Stepped into the gas station's garage. It was dark and quiet. The place was a mess. It looked like someone trashed the place or that there'd been some kind of fight. Light spilled into the room through an open door at the back, and I made my way toward it. Without any warning, I was blinded by a bright light. An old portable TV on the shelf had come alive by itself. Impossibly, I could see myself on the screen, talking like a madman.
Find him and run! Fuck you!
Jesus, a flare gun. They gonna give me all the flare gun ammo. I'm gonna be popping flares. You stop that.
I never touch salad, though. A man like me needs a hefty
meal.
That's for today.
Man, I'm actually hungry for a salad. Like, he'd make, like, a really good, like, salad, put some cheese and dressing on there, a bunch of other shit. You can get some really good salads, and then if, like, you could throw that into a fucking wrap, like, so, man, now I'm hungry for a wrap. No!
We enjoy the magnificent!
Oh, of course.
Cabin on Cauldron Lake? She asked. The sheriff looked at me suspiciously. The early morning light flooded through the office windows. I would probably never have gotten out of the woods alive without her help. But I couldn't tell her the truth of what I'd faced the previous night. She'd think I was lying or crazy. She'd lock me up, and she wouldn't help me find Alice.
Thank you.
shotgun.
Science. It bestows immortality on those who advance it to elevate all of mankind. Newton, Einstein, Sagan, princes among men. But the price for such a legacy is steep indeed. In Night Springs. Tonight's episode, A Quantum Suicide. If our lives are already written, it would take a courageous man to change the script. Having called a press conference, Dr. Barclay Colvin is about to demonstrate that very courage.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, I am Dr. Barclay Colvin, and I'm glad so many of you could join me here at the Moorcock Institute. Tonight, I'm going to give a practical demonstration of the many worlds interpretation. As you can see, this is a loaded 9mm pistol. It shall be part of a thought experiment. And now, a real experiment, known as a quantum suicide.
Did he say suicide? Is that a real gun? He's kidding, right?
Please, please, stay calm. There is no risk. Observe what occurs when I place the weapon against my own forehead. Now, you might think this round is merely a dud. Not so. Observe the flower pot. And yet, I myself cannot be harmed with this gun. With each pull of the trigger, two new realities branch off. One in which the weapon didn't fire, and one where it did. With my machine here, I have ensured that this reality is always the former. I have bestowed upon myself quantum immortality. Under no circumstances can this gun kill me.
So wait. What you're saying is that every time you pull the trigger, in another reality, you die?
Yes, of course, but that's completely trivial. There's an infinite number of things that could happen at any moment, and they always do happen somewhere. The point is, this one thing did not happen here.
You're insane, Colvin.
Insane? Insane?
Hey, was this thing supposed to be plugged in? I stumbled on it.
You fools! Gaze upon quantum immortality!
Poor, poor Dr. Colvin. Felled by his own hubris or the ignorance of the masses. Perhaps he should have left the crate unopened, the decaying atom unobserved. Curiosity often kills the cat. In Night Springs.
I love good Twilight rip or Twilight Zone ripoffs. Dude survive.
Thank you.
Carl.
Oh. It kills people, Carl.
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come, assuming I'd reach the lights at the gas station alive.
This is just a big lake. Arena. No, no extras lying about. For me to pick up. I guess not.
I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice.
I'm on a car! I'm on... Ooh.
Almost sounds like the Terminator theme. Dun 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 dun. Dun 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 dun.
After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself. Stucky spat on the garage floor and tried to shake the cobwebs from his head. Ever since the couple never showed to pick up the keys, things had been fuzzy. Something, a feeling, caught his attention. Stucky looked up and stared as his brain tried in vain to process the horror before him. He stumbled back, knocking over a can of oil. A black pool spread across the floor while he struggled for a brief moment, then let go as the unrelenting darkness engulfed him.
Then he talked about hot dogs.
The Deer Fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now.
Damn. I know this game's like semi-old, but they have almost realistic gas prices. Though, honestly, I feel like they might have been putting him up there because, you know, they were just being like, ah, ha, ha, joke. And now you, like, look back and you're like, damn, that didn't age well. This gas price is dumb. That's not a good sound. Is there nothing else out?
Oh lord. Oh lord!
Inside the gas station to find a phone to call for help.
Coffee thermos already got one? Oh, wow. Let me check this way.
Oh God.
Is something on the back of the... Oh my god. Don't tell me.
Kirby knew the smell. It was the man. The nice man who always gave him treats and never got tired of playing with him. Toby wagged his tail in excited anticipation and gave a joyous bark. Then there was another smell. A wrong smell. And it was alien enough to stop Toby in his tracks. Confused, he growled deep in his throat. The wrong smell came from the nice man. Blind animal terror pierced the dog's brain an instant before the axe followed suit.
Aww.
So, Toby.
The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
All right. I'll keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her. I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this. It'd been me on the TV, talking crazy. Was I losing my mind?
My mind.
The 68th Annual Deer Fest, September 15th to 18th. Games and activities, raffle tickets, fishing competition, pie contest, and surprise competitions, live music for the children, Bucktooth Charlie in the Afternoons, and Montgomery the Mystic's Amazing Phantasmagora Evenings. Don't miss the legendary Deer Fest Parade. Hey, Nordic Walking. Oh. He kept talking about that. He's losing his shit.
We sell propane, but where's the propane accessories? Oh!
Great Falls Sheriff Station.
Oh, thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Listen...
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake, and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
Candy-colored clown they call the Sandman tiptoes to my room every night, and just to sprinkle stardust and to whisper go to sleep, everything is all right. I close my eyes, then I drift away into night. I softly say a silent prayer, like dreamers do. Then I fall asleep to dream my dreams of you. In dreams, I walk with you. In dreams I talk to you. In dreams you're mine. All of the time we're together. I can't help it if I cry.